Hey, it's Alex Allman with Revolutionary Sex. Today, I want to talk to you about an issue that is troubling for a lot of men, penis size. I'm going to talk about three things today, and then I'm going to make a quick request. I'll lead with the request, which is, if you're a woman watching this video, I think you might find it interesting, and I'd really appreciate it if you have a comment for the men about penis size that you want to leave below. I think hearing from women on this subject is important for men. First thing I want to talk about in the video is penis enlargement. It's a hot topic. We're going to discuss that. Second thing I want to talk to you about is whether or not size matters and what you can do about it. And the third thing I want to talk about is man to man, what it means if you do have a small penis. First of all, penis enlargement. This is a really huge industry. People are making hundreds of millions of dollars selling pills, pumps, and exercise techniques to enlarge the penis. And with that much money on the line, the question is, are any of them effective? And if so, which ones? And I have pretty much bad news for you here. Urologists, penis doctors, who see patients every single month and tell me that they're seeing more and more injuries to the penis because of weights and stretching exercises and penis pumps, they'll tell you don't do it. And I'm going to come down on their side of it. There is actually no scientific evidence that doing any of these things actually increases the size of your penis. There are a lot of stories on the internet about men who say, I did it, I grew a bigger penis. The problem is, I haven't found a whole lot of it that isn't on a penis enlargement website. So you do the math. Now, the other possibility, of course, is seeing your doctor for some surgery. It's the kind of thing you're going to want to discuss carefully with your doctor. I think very few men who talk to their doctor about the possible side effects and the best case scenario outcomes are going to want to go ahead with penis enlargement surgery, but that's between you and your doctor. Second thing is, does size matter? And I would love to look you in the eye and say, look, size doesn't matter. But, you know, you expect authenticity and the truth from me, and you're always going to get it. The truth is that size does matter, and it matters differently to different women. I've talked to an awful lot of women about this subject, and obviously it's the kind of thing that I would have to talk to women about to get some really serious feedback on. I really have talked to a large number of women about it. Most women that I've spoken to have said the penis size does matter. The vast majority of them say that there is definitely something called too big. There are very few women out there who are like, no, man, the bigger the better. There's a lot of men that say that about breasts. Not so many women will say that about the penis. Most women prefer an average size penis. Some prefer it a little larger than average size, and some women prefer a large penis, mostly for the visual effect. It's a turn on to look at. They generally won't be able to tell the difference in bed, at least, again, according to studies that have actually been done on blindfolded women who are well lubricated. So the real question is, do you need to be insecure about your penis size? And I'm going to answer that a couple of ways. The first is to tell you that you can give a woman orgasms until she literally passes out because she can't take any more pleasure using nothing but one small finger. In fact, I'll bet you could do it with this finger. And given that, I think that it's clear that you could sexually satisfy a woman with any size penis. The second factor is that even for women who like a larger penis, if you ask them, well, large penis versus broad shoulders or a good smile or a dominant man that knows what he's doing in bed, most of them are not going to rate the big penis at the top of that list. In fact, damn few of them. So I've really made a career at this point of speaking to hundreds of women about what was dissatisfying to them in bed. Almost never does the penis size thing come up in that conversation. And finally, I think it is worth mentioning that there are some women who like small penises. I mean, for sure. I've actually spoken to women who looked me in the eye and they said that they prefer a penis that's below average in size, and that's where their attraction lies. That's what feels best for them. This is the same kind of issue that a fat man faces, a bald man faces, a short man faces, a disabled man faces. There is no perfect human on this planet, and all of us are going to enter into life with things that we're great at and things that we're not so good at, things that we're very proud of and things that we're ashamed of. The reality is that none of these things matter to women, half as much as they're going to matter to you, and they will matter to women to the exact degree that they matter to you. And this is your opportunity to grow as a man and to reach acceptance. Life isn't fair, and the biggest unfairness of all, and everything else is a distraction from this, the biggest unfairness of all is you're going to die, and there's nothing you can do about that one, nothing at all. And if you really look at it that way, it really, that's the piece that equalizes everything else as a man. The same is true of so many things in life. There's nothing you can do about it. And your grace and your capacity to own that as a man and to work within that framework and love yourself and love the world that you were born into that exists exactly as it is the mission of every man who wants to claim the title of man. And I answer emails from men all the time who say, women don't like me because I'm short, or women don't like me because I'm a different race, or women don't like me because of I'm bald. Stop hiding behind the secret excuse of penis size. It's beneath you, and you can do better than that. And I hope you take this seriously. This is a real opportunity for you to grow, perhaps not in length, but in wisdom. This is Alex Allman with Revolutionary Sex. Thanks for listening, and I will see you again next Thursday.